Carrying what little they have, a family attempts to flee the fighting in rebel-held East Aleppo. Pro-government forces backed by Russian warplanes and Iranian-sponsored militias have been pounding the area relentlessly for weeks, seizing more than 80% of the rebel-held territory. Regime forces captured the Mahdi neighborhood on Sunday. The loss is yet another sign the armed opposition is on the verge of losing control of Syria's largest city.
The fall of Aleppo or any other city or town doesn't mean the end to the revolution. The revolution doesn't end in a city or town. It's an ideology, and the ideology will never die.
State-controlled Syrian television showed this video, which is said to show hundreds of civilians on the streets of Aleppo moving to government-controlled areas. Thousands are believed to have fled the fighting in recent days, while around 100,000 civilians remain in the besieged territory.
Many civilians who fled to regime areas have already been arrested. In some cases, they were killed because they were accused of collaborating with the opposition. So civilians know that if they leave to regime areas, it's like going to hell.
The fall of rebel-held East Aleppo to forces fighting for President Bashar al-Assad would be their biggest victory since the start of the war more than 5 years ago. Diplomatic efforts are underway as part of attempts to reduce the fighting and ease the humanitarian crisis in the shrinking rebel territory. There are reports that the United States and Russia have agreed to a proposal which would see multiple safe passages for rebel fighters, their families, and civilians trapped inside of besieged East Aleppo. Moscow is denying the report, saying that no agreement has been reached, and rebel fighters have said that they too haven't decided on whether or not they would agree to any such proposal. So until that happens, the brutal fighting in East Aleppo will continue. Imtiaz Hai, Al Jazeera, Gaziantep, on the Turkish-Syrian border.